The Commander in Chief, President Yoweri Museveni, has made new changes in the leadership of the security agencies of the country, appointing Lieutenant General Muhoozi Kainerugaba new commander of the Special Forces Command and Presidential Advisor on Security. Muhoozi was dropped from the same position back in 2017. President Museveni has also replaced the deputy police boss, Major General Sabit Muzei, with Major General Paul Lokech, who has been on a special assignment to monitor the demobilization and integration of South Sudan troops, and has been replaced by Major General James Birungi, who has been the commander of the Special Forces Command. Muzei, who was appointed Deputy Inspector General of Police in March 2018, has been sent to the military headquarters for redeployment. UPDF Deputy Spokesperson Lieutenant Colonel Dewa Kiki says that some appointments await parliamentary approval for the newly assigned officers to start their jobs. In a statement, President Museveni expressed his disappointment in the way police is handling what he terms as lawlessness in the country. The president, who is also commander-in-chief, said the police force must be made to do its duty of defending Ugandans from lawlessness, threat to life and property, further noting that any police person that does not do what is expected of him must leave the police. Could this have been the reason for the changes? Could it?
Well, so there you have it.
Looking at what has been written about the new deputy police, Inspector General of Police, I was thinking when the appointing authority started deploying military generals in the police, it was criticized by parliament and civil society. But within me, I'm thinking, was the deployment of military generals in police, has it changed anything?
Mm-hmm.
Looking at a major general Lokech, he's been written about as a very decisive person who takes decisions that can avert war. Are we heading to war that we need somebody? This is what has been written about him. And they give us his profile where he launched his first offensive, where, I mean, what does this mean, like you asked?
Mm-hmm.
In the past, about 20 years ago, we used to have police that was that had real policemen. You remember the Chisembos, other police IGPs that we had. But I think starting with the General Katumba Wamala, that's when we started seeing military generals being appointed to head the police.
That's true.
And everybody expected at the time when General Katumba entered the police force that something was going to, and the police image was going to change. I don't know. I don't give the marks to General Katumba and others like Kaihura, who came after him, whether the police image changed or it did not. But I think Uganda is will continue to see more of a collage of police, senior police officers and the military generals taking over the mantle at the police force. But whatever this means, I think in the story that the New Vision has written, they took over of General
Lokech
as a media-friendly person who...
We shall see that.
Okay, we shall see that. And looking at Major General Muzei Sabiti, yesterday I overheard somebody describing who Sabiti is. He's a humble man who reads his Bible, who... Okay, now my question is, now when you do replace Sabit with Lokech, what does that mean? Which signal does it send now that we have a few days left to...
Yes, that's true.
It's for somebody who thinks through
to make an assessment. But you see, what gets my attention, what you mentioned, that when they started bringing together military and police, I remember when they changed the Uganda police, what was it called previously, before force?
I think it was called Uganda Police.
I think so. Mm. And then they said Uganda Police. Force. Mm. I think that is when things changed.
And I had one candidate who says when he comes into power, he's going to change it to Uganda Police Service. That is not supposed to be a force. Mm-hmm. It's supposed to be a service because it's supposed to offer services to
people. Mm. Absolutely. Well, so those are the changes. We are yet to see how they will, you know, go about. Some of them are yet to be approved by Parliament. We're going to see when Parliament will sit and, you know, approve this. But those are the changes we're going to, you know, going forward. We'll see how that will play up for us. Now, we're going to get into a very interesting discussion. Yes, we've been having these discussions, but it seems most of you are still very complacent and very reluctant to take care of your lives. We are going to speak to Dr. Grace Nambatia. She's the Director of Research at National Chemotherapeutical Institute, and she's here to discuss on how you can boost your immunity against COVID-19. There are very interesting things I have seen on social media. Mm-hmm. Steaming. Mm. Guys, calm down. Steaming your face, steaming your... Yeah, so you put concoctions together and then you steam. I wish you could talk about that as well. Then there's also some drinks you have to take, pineapple something. She's going to explain those things.
Speaking about the concoctions, mm-hmm. The other day on social media still, I saw somebody suggesting that you mix lemon with soda bicarbonate. I don't know. The doctor should tell us.
The doctor is here. She's in the building. She's going to tell us how you can boost your immunity against COVID-19. Don't get caught unawares. We're going to have her here in just a bit. Do stick around.